Hello everyone, and welcome to another Students of S.H.I.E.L.D. podcast on everybody's favorite genius, billionaire, playboy, and philanthropist, Tony Stark. As we continue our discussion of Iron Man's many armors, we go back to his roots with his very first suit of armor, with commentary from one of our very first members of the Students of S.H.I.E.L.D., Chris Valera.
The Iron Man Model 1, known as the Gray Armor, Original Armor, and Mark Zero, made its debut in Tales of Suspense number 39 in March of 1963. In this issue, Iron Man was born when Tony Stark was ambushed and subsequently kidnapped by the Wong Chu and forced to build weapons for the evil Viet Cong leader. With the help of Ho Yinsen, Tony was able to construct the armor out of pieces of scrap metal while developing an electric mechanism to stop the shrapnel from reaching his heart. With Professor Yinsen's sacrifice, Tony was able to escape capture and return to the States with his newly developed suit.
After returning to his factory on Long Island, New York, Tony went to work making modifications to the original armor, including reducing the size of the chest plate so he could wear it underneath his civilian clothes for quick access recharging. The armor would later be painted all gold to appear less menacing to innocent bystanders. Throughout Iron Man's history, the Mark Zero armor has been needed to defeat many of Iron Man's enemies over the years. In order to defeat the Melter, Tony rebuilt the Mark Zero out of aluminum to resist the Melter's ray.
Unlike many of the armors that would be developed like Tony, the Mark Zero primarily served as a pacemaker for Tony's damaged heart, with very few external weapons. The suit augmented the user's strength enough to withstand bullets and destroy brick and metal walls. Flamethrowers and tear gas bombs were among the weaponry implemented in the Mark Zero armor. The chest plate also featured a monobeam, the first form of what would later be Iron Man's signature unibeam.
The Mark Zero armor made its debut in the Marvel Cinematic Universe as the Mark One armor in 2008's Iron Man. The movie armor included an arc reactor that powered the suit and also protected Tony's heart. The suit also included a missile launcher and a boost thruster that could only be used for temporary flight. The recovered pieces of armor left behind from Tony's escape would be recovered by Obadiah Stane to create the Ironmonger.
The Mark Zero armor signified the birth of Iron Man in the Marvel Universe with an iconic and memorable look that has been translated to the big screen and other animated shows. This suit would be the basis of all armors that would soon follow its creation. I would like to thank Dan and the Students of S.H.I.E.L.D. for having me on. Make sure to subscribe for more Students of S.H.I.E.L.D. videos, and thanks for watching.